Set kid, and it's 2021. Nothing's open yet, so we're just preparing for the new season. So I turned 12 last year, so we upgraded my 99 Johnson to a 40 Mariner. So today, we are mounting the motor, mounting the controls, hooking up the electronics, and firing the motor up for the first time. We're back, and right now I'm just going to be showing you guys around my boat. Well, we got it in the water a few days ago. We went on a boat ride yesterday. We have almost everything hooked up, and I'm just going to be showing you around, a little tour, showing you the switches, the features. So these are the first switches we're going to look at. So this is the main. What it does is it basically like turns on all of the other things in the boat. Like in order to use these four switches or for them to work, the main has to be turned on. Okay, so after the first switch, so these are the nav lights. So basically if you turn it on, it won't work right now because I don't have the lights hooked in, but there will be a light up at the front of the boat, and it's red and green to show which side of the boat is which in the night. It's for other boats, and then there's one right there, but we don't have them in right now, so they won't turn on. The next, we have the bilge, so if I turn this on, it pumps out water out of the boat. So that's the bilge right there. It pumps out water from inside of the main, so pump water out of right there or in the boat. And then the next, we have the aerator, which is for the live wells. It like it's like a bubbler for the live wells, and it oxygenates the water in the live wells. Another thing in the boat is a fish finder. So if we turn on the main switch, which gives power to everything, and we come up here, and we press this button, it should turn on. So it's a Hummingbird Fish Hunter 570X. It's just vertical, and it just shows depth, what the bottom looks like, the fish. Okay, so the next thing I have in my boat is live wells. So as you can see, the main's on. We come up here to the front of the boat, and we turn on this switch right here. Either of them work. I'll just go to auto. Then it should start putting water into the live well. So there's a live well right here at the front. It's a bigger live well. You could probably fit like a 24-inch pike in there. And then if you go around to the back live well, just right here, this one should be filling up as well. So this is how you deploy my trolling motor. So what you want to do is you want to take this cord and pull it back so that the lock here unlocks. Then you just lift it up, push forward, and then it just sits in like that. So basically what you do to steer it is you push your foot forward to make it go to the right and your foot back to make it go left. And if you see this little red button right here, that shows which direction you're going. So if you push it forward, as I said earlier, it goes to the right, to the left if I push back. And so right here is the different switches. So there's the off switch, which is in the middle. Momentary, which means like when you press the button, it works. And then constant, which means it's constantly just moving. Okay, so another thing we have is right here. It is a storage unit. We're going to turn it into a rod locker. So basically, if you gotta spin this, it sits down like that. Push this, spin it around, lift it up. And then storage thing. Right now we just have life jackets. We have the mandatory things that you need. We have life jackets, a paddle, bailing bucket, and some other stuff. And so that's what it's for, and we're gonna turn it into a rod locker soon. So what we're gonna do is down there, we're gonna put tubes or pipes, you could say, and you just slide the tip of the rod into there, and then it will hold it. Okay, so first what you wanna do is get gas in the motor. You wanna make sure that this squishy ball is tight, because that means that it's full of gas. You just want to squeeze it until it's tight, and then once it's tight, it's probably good. That's probably fine, because we're not going anywhere. So then, what you want to do is, I'm going to come down here, and I'm going to lift this for fast idle, just so it doesn't die. It gets the RPMs higher, so the motor doesn't die when we first start it, and after it warms up, I just put it down. So, what we want to do, because it's a cold start, you twist the key, push it in, and then twist it again, and that will start it. So I already have it twisted. I'm gonna push it in, and then and again. Thanks for watching. I'm so excited for this season, and stay tuned for some early season pike fishing.